So this is the reproductive health. Last topic is left. Fourth chapter, reproductive health. Last topic, that is art. What is this art? Art doesn't mean the art and craft like art. This art is assisted reproductive technologies, right? So we have certain of the reproductive technologies which have been assisting the infertile couples. Okay, so this is assisted reproductive technology. These technologies, they are actually assisting, as the name is saying, assisted reproductive technology. So they are assisting the infertile couples. What do you understand by the infertile couples? What do you mean by infertility? That is not undergoing the fertilization. Okay, infertility means that is a person can't be fertile. A person can't be, can't conceive. The females can't conceive the child, the fetus, that is they are infertile, right? Now the infertility, depending upon what is the reason of the infertility, what are the basic problems concerned with their infertility, the techniques will be chosen from the list. Because there are a long list of those techniques which are involved, and depending upon what is the reason of the parent being infertile. Is the reason concerned with only the female? Is the reason concerned with the male or both the partners? Okay. Then is this infertility because the mother can't support the child? Mother body is not in such a manner that it is not developed in such a manner that it support nahi kar sakti child ko, fetus developments ko support nahi kar sakti. Okay. So wo cases aa sakte hain yahan pe. So depending upon whatsoever are the cases, depending upon the reason for being infertile, the art technique will be you can say chosen, and hence it will be applied to that infertile couple, right? The very first and the foremost technique in this art, that is the very common type of technique, it is IVF, in vitro fertilization. This is in vitro fertilization. In vitro fertilization means that is the fertilization is taking place in some artificial conditions. In vitro means artificial environment. That is among the lab conditions, we can say, laboratory conditions. Okay. So this IVF is taking place within the labs, in the artificial conditions provided for the germination of the male and the female gamete, for the fertilization and hence the germination. Okay. Now what is done in this IVF? How it is done? This is basically the gametes from the two resources, that is from both the parents, male and the female, the gametes are taken, right? Female gamete, ova is collected from the female mother body, and the male gamete is also collected from the father's body. Both have been collected out. They have been collected from the ovary and the testes respectively, and they have been collected in the artificial conditions. Artificial conditions in the laboratory have been provided for these to undergo the fertilization process. Okay, ye dono jab fertilize karenge to kya banayenge? They will be resulting into the zygote, right? Now a condition arises. Yahan to ye hua ki male or female body jo hai, if they are not supporting, if they are actually not, if the body is not supporting, or the male and the female gametes, they are not, you can say they are not capable of passing out the male gametes into the female body. The female gamete is not receiving the male gametes, or some changes like that have been there in the body of the two. Then the gametes are taken out from the body. In the artificial conditions, they are kept for undergoing the fertilization, resulting into the zygote formation. Zygote ban gaya. ठीक है. जब ये zygote बन गया, अब यहाँ पे भी difference आता है कि अगर इसमें IVF is followed by any of the two techniques further, ठीक है, IVF बस इतना है कि जब इसको हमने fertilize करवा दिया, ये IVF है, ठीक है, it can be followed by two of the further techniques. If the body of the female, zygote कहाँ develop होता है female में? Fertilization takes place within the fallopian tube, you know, पढ़ा है हमने third chapter में, embryo-isthmus junction. तो वहां पे जब ये zygote बन गया, fallopian tube में बना ना, अगर mother की fallopian tube अगर वो सपोर्ट करती है डेवलपमेंट को, तो ये जायगॉट फिलोपियन ट्यूब में ट्रांसफर कर दिया जाएगा. ठीक है, दैट टेक्निक इफ द जायगोट इज ट्रांसफर्ड इट इज कॉल्ड एज ZIFT, जायगोट इंट्राफिलोपियन ट्रांसफर. ठीक है, दिस इज अ फर्दर टेक्निक, IVF फॉलोड बाय ZIFT, दैट इज जायगोट इंट्राफिलोपियन ट्रांसफर. इंट्राफिलोपियन ट्रांसफर if this is supported by the female's body, but if not, the zygote is not supported in the fallopian tubes, then this zygote is allowed to keep in the laboratory conditions and undergo the further development, that is for 2 to 6 days. Further after the zygote formation, 2 to 6 days development is more taking place, leading to the formation of embryo. Now to embryo ban jayega. जब एम्ब्रियो तैयार है, अब एम्ब्रियो की ट्रांसफर कहां करवाई जाएगी? दैट इज विद इन द यूट्रस पार्ट. ठीक है, द एम्ब्रियो विल बी ट्रांसफर्ड इनटू द यूट्रस. ठीक है, सो दैट आर कॉल्ड एज अ ईटी टेक्निक्स. ईटी टेक्निक, दैट इज एम्ब्रियो ट्रांसफर टेक्निक्स. दिस इज व्हाट वी कॉल इट एज, एम्ब्रियो ट्रांसफर. डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दैट द फीमेल body supports zygote or an embryo, this will be taking place. Either the zygote is given to the fallopian tube within the body of the female mother, or the embryo is given to the uterus, directly to the uterus for the further implantation and all, so that this can lead to the bearing, giving up of the birth to the child. So that is by the female body. Now if in this case अगर ये भी नहीं सपोर्ट किया जाता तो एम्ब्रियो लिया जाएगा. अगर एम्ब्रियो में यूट्रस भी सपोर्ट नहीं करता तो क्या होगा? अगर एम्ब्रियो की डेवलपमेंट भी अगर एक मदर की बॉडी जो है वो नहीं सपोर्ट करती तो क्या होता है? देन द वूम ऑफ सम अदर मदर इज टेकन, दैट इज दिस एम्ब्रियो, दैट इज ऑफ दिस इनफर्टाइल कपल. इफ द मदर इज स्टिल नॉट सपोर्टिंग द एम्ब्रियो, मतलब मदर की बॉडी इतनी ज्यादा वीक है या इतना ज्यादा उसके अंदर कुछ कम्प्लेक्शंस हैं जिसकी वजह से एम्ब्रियो भी ट्रांसफर कर दिया जाए तो भी इसके अंदर क्या है, दैट विल नॉट बी टेकिंग, डेवलपमेंट विल नॉट बी टेकिंग प्लेस. देन अंडर सच कंडीशंस द फीमेल्स, दिस कपल्स गेमीट और द जायगोट और द एम्ब्रियो, डिपेंडिंग ऑन एम्ब्रियो इज बेसिकली डन, दैट इज गिवन टू सम अदर मदर एंड दैट मदर इज कॉल्ड एज अ सरोगेट मदर. So this is, the process is called as of surrogacy. That is, this embryo, if not supported by the mother of this couple, infertile couple ka, mother mein agar support nahi hota hai, to koi aur mother, jo willing ladies hain, usme ye embryo ko transfer kar diya jayega. The child will have the characteristics of the parents only, but it will be developed in the womb of some other female. Right? Such female is called as a surrogate mother. So depending upon the condition, I'm saying, okay, depending upon the condition, IVF is one technique. It is followed by either the ZIFT, that is a second technique, or ET, that is a third technique, or surrogacy, that is a fourth technique, but that are all connected, interconnected. Okay, this is when the male and female gametes are taken in artificial conditions and they are allowed to fertilize. Clear? Right? Now further is next technique. After this, if the female body, sorry, if the male gamete that is not capable of having the male gamete does not has the capacity to fertilize, to undergo the fertilization with the ova. Male gametes, they are not having that particular capability to undergo the fertilization with the ova. Then what is done? There is intracytoplasmic sperm injection. This technique is then called ICSI, that is intracytoplasmic sperm injection. What is done in this technique? the ova that is ready to receive the male gametes nucleus, है ना, ova तो developed है, वो पूरी तरह से ले सकता है, that is male gamete, ठीक है, it can receive the male gamete, but the male gametes they are not capable of it, they are not capable of going and then going to fuse all the layers of the ova and then fuse with the ova's nucleus, ठीक है, so under that condition what is done is the male gametes they are directly taken, that is the material from the male gamete is taken and that is injected directly into the cytoplasm of the ova, ठीक है, that is it is directly injected into the cytoplasm of the ova. Now this can't be done within the body of the female, है ना, ये चीज फीमेल की बॉडी के अंदर नहीं लोकेट किया जा सकता, so under that condition the ova from the female and the male gametes from the male body they are both taken, they are both taken in the artificial conditions and the male gametes material is all injected within the cytoplasm of the ova, yani jo inject kar rahe hain hum log material, that material you can just simply symbolically this I am showing, this is the material from the male gamete, that is the sperm, and this is an ova, so directly this material is transferred into the cytoplasm of the ova, that is why we call this as intracytoplasmic sperm injection, ठीक है, so this is intracytoplasmic sperm injection, ICSI, clear? As there is one technique for gamete, this zygote transfer, that is ZIFT, so is another technique for gametes transfer, we call it as GIFT. That is gamete intrafallopian transfer, not the zygote intrafallopian transfer. This is now gamete intrafallopian transfer. Gamete intrafallopian transfer, GIFT. As the name is saying now, again the gametes are to be transferred within the fallopian tube. But why? The gametes are produced by ovary, they themselves will be coming out from the ovary into the fallopian tube, then why it is a need for this? It is because if the gametes, they are not undergoing the full development within the ovary, okay, they are not undergoing the full development, what is done is the ovaries, from the ovaries of the female, the gamete is collected out, put into the artificial medium for a few days and it is allowed to get all those changes which are required in it. ठीक है, वो सारी डेवलपमेंटल चेंजेस जो हैं वो चाहिए हैं कि मीट के अंदर वो ले ली विद इन द आर्टिफिशियल कंडीशंस, फर्टिलाइजेशन नहीं करवाया, आईवीएफ नहीं है, ठीक है, यहाँ फर्टिलाइजेशन नहीं करवाया, सिर्फ गेमीट्स निकाले बॉडी में से और उनको रखा कुछ देर के लिए बाहर आर्टिफिशियल कंडीशन में, जस्ट सो दैट दे कैन अंडरगो द डेवलपमेंटल चेंजेस प्रॉपरली, आफ्टर दिस दे आर डायरेक्टली इंजेक्टेड इन टू द फिलोपियन ट्यूब एंड दे विल देमसेल्व्स अंडरगो द फर्टिलाइजेशन, देर वॉज नो प्रॉब्लम ऑफ द फर्टिलाइजेशन और द डेवलपमेंट, समझ गए, कोई प्रॉब्लम ऐसा नहीं था कि फिलोपियन ट्यूब्स उसको सपोर्ट नहीं कर रही है फर्टिलाइजेशन के लिए या यूटरस बॉडी सपोर्ट नहीं कर रही है इम्प्लांटेशन के लिए, ये सारी प्रॉब्लम्स नहीं थी, प्रॉब्लम क्या था, गेमीट डेवलप नहीं हो रहा, ठीक है, सो क्या किया यहाँ पे कल्चर मीडियम में गेमीट्स को अलग कर लिया, ठीक है, गेमीट्स निकाले रखा थोड़ी देर के लिए कल्चर मीडियम में, फिर उसके बाद ये डेवलप हुआ एंड देन दिस मीडियम इज डायरेक्टली ट्रांसफर्ड इन टू द fallopian tubes, ये fallopian tubes हैं, ठीक है, this is then transferred into the fallopian tube before the fertilization site, site से पहले, ampelismus junction से पहले, ताकि ये अपने आप fertilization करें, here the fertilization will be done by themselves, these gametes only, okay, got it, so this is the technique called as GIFT, so these are the few techniques which are there in your NCERT. From this topic of art, you may be asked that what can be the reason for infertility? You may be asked the reason for choosing this ICSI, है ना? ऐसा करके आपको क्योंकि MCQs है, तो आपको MCQs में इस तरह से question आ सकते हैं. Which of the following is a reason that the couple has gone for this ICSI technique? है ना? या which of the following reasons are there? So the mother that adopted for the surrogacy. है ना, तो कुछ इस तरह से आपको क्वेश्चंस जो हैं दे विल बी आस्क्ड फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक, अदरवाइज दीज ऑल आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड दिस इज अगेन अ वेरी सिंपल बट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक एंड दिस विद दिस नाउ we finish our whole syllabus of term one. Your full syllabus of term one is done. Okay. Anybody having any question, any doubts? Yes.